Hello, hello. So today I am going to tell you my must-haves when you go on a cruise. Y'all know I love a good cruise. I've been on many cruises. I've tried different cruise ships. Cruising is a big industry. I think it's estimated that almost 36 billion people will be cruising in 2024. That's a lot. It's a lot. It's a lot of people. The U.S. is obviously number one with how many people cruise. The top cruise lines, I believe it goes, let me check. Carnival, Royal, Celebrity, Norwegian, Princess, Holland, MSC, Virgin, and Disney. And I'm not here to tell you which cruise I like better. We can do a video on that if y'all want, but I'm literally just here to share some fun cruising facts and to tell you my essentials to bring on the ship. But let me know if you would like to do a, if you would like me to do a video where I compare the cruise lines. I can tell you how to just get on a cruise with just a carry-on if you don't want to wait on your bag. That's another thing. I do that for shorter cruises. I definitely do not do that for cruises that are longer. The busiest cruise ports. I knew number one would be Miami. I knew Port Canaveral would be up there. I thought Bahamas would be like two or three, but three is actually Cozumel, which I knew would be up there, but I didn't think it would be higher than the Bahamas. So it goes Miami, Port Canaveral, Cozumel, Nassau, Barcelona, which I know is one of the biggest ports over there in Europe. Then it's Port Everglades, which is Fort Lauderdale. And then it is the port in Italy. And Galveston, my home port, is number 11. Okay, so the average cruise ship has about 3,000 passengers, about 1,000 crew. Obviously, these new mega ships can hold like 6,000 or 7,000. It's insane. They just keep getting bigger and better and more extreme and fun, honestly. I think it's great. I love cruising. I like visiting other places too, but I just think cruising is a very easy vacation. You don't really have to think of much. You have so much entertainment right there on the ship. You don't have to really think about where to go for dinner because like literally just be like, wing it. You can go to the buffet if that's your thing. You can go to the specialty dining. You can just go to the main restaurant. Obviously, every cruise line does things different. Like I said, I'm not going to go into that. I can do a video if you want me to compare them. But today, without further ado, I'm going to give you my cruise ship essentials. So first things first, you're going to have to print your luggage tag. I've seen people staple them. Whatever. If that's your thing, that's fine. I personally would not do it without getting one of these plastic things to put your luggage tag in. They are not all the same size, so definitely make sure it works for your cruise. Okay, this is my first thing, cruise tag. Second thing, you will have you need a lanyard for your card, your sea pass, your sail inside, whatever. I forgot what Disney calls it. I haven't been on a Disney cruise in a while. They all have different names. It's a little credit card that basically is your key to everything. It opens and closes your door. It's how they swipe it. It's how you pay for your drinks. It's how they see if you have a drink package or not. I will not get into drink packages on this, but I can, again, I can do another video. But these are great. Bring a hole puncher if you wanna use like this type of thing to put it on, and then you know, you don't have to take it off. You can also put it in the little card slots. The other thing that I sometimes do, and I forgot to bring mine, I'm so annoyed. I have one of those phone cases where you can put a credit card in the back, and I like that. Sometimes I don't want to wear a lanyard if I'm out tanning or whatever, and I just put it in one of those. Those are your options. I suggest if you have a kid, get them a lanyard so they don't lose it. It's my suggestion. Will you get seasick on a cruise? I don't know. You may not. I tend to not. But, you know, some people do. As far as medicine, you can get good old Bonine, whatever, however you want to pronounce it. This is one of the better ones that you can get without a prescription. If you get really seasick, I would suggest going to your doctor and getting a prescription. Some of these, obviously, can make you drowsy. So I like the natural Dramamine, which is ginger. It works for me. It may not be strong enough. And I've only had to use this once when the seas were really rough, just to kind of help me sleep. And I was fine the next day when I woke up. Some people like these little C bands that you put like on your pulse points here. I think I put them on my son on the first cruise and he was fine, but I don't know if it was the C bands or he was just fine, honestly. So I can't tell you if these work. And then there's also the little stickers that you can do behind your ears that I've seen people. So I definitely would suggest bringing some just in case, because if you wait till you're on the ship, it's gonna be very expensive or they might sell out if you hit rough waters. So just be prepared. These are like my cabin must. They never have enough plugs. So you wanna bring one of these so you can put in your phones, put in whatever you need to plug in. And be aware that every cruise ship is different. And even some of the ports are pickier than some. Most of them are non-surge protect. You cannot have a surge protector on it. Some of them will only allow the ones that plug directly in. Like you can't have the corded ones because it's considered a fire hazard. Some say that the Galveston port is like stricter than others, but I will say I have gotten on with a corded one before. I don't suggest doing it because, again, it just depends on who you get. So I wouldn't. I would try to get one like this. And all these things I am going to link. I made a whole list on Amazon to make your life easier, and you can check that list out. I am a germaphobe. I like to Lysol as soon as I get into my cabin. I literally Lysol all the doors, all the like lights, and all the like the phone, the remotes. I do it once and then I'm good. I mean, I know it's crazy, right? You're on a ship, but whatever. It's just something I do. So this might not be a necessity for everyone, but it is for me. Poo-pourri, you will thank me later. Seriously, you want this in your bathroom. It's a tight space on a cruise. Trust me, trust me, trust me. Also, the soap they give you sucks. I always bring my own antibacterial pump soap. I actually do this a lot when I travel in general. I do it when I go to the Disney resorts, depending on which one I'm staying at. Because a lot of, even the nicer hotels will just have hand soaps and yeah, no. Okay, I guess we'll address the Stanley. I actually usually bring a water bottle, not a Stanley, because I like doing the tracker. I like going to the gym, so I prefer a water bottle. But water bottle, Stanley, I like having one to keep my drinks cold. It's a preference. You don't really need one, but I like having one. Bring a first aid kit because, yes, there's medics, there's medical, but if you just have a cut or it's something small, do you really want to deal with all that? Or do you really want to go downstairs and pay like 5 times the price for a Band-Aid? No, you don't. So bring a little medical kit. Bring some aspirin, obviously. Bring all that. Bring anything like that that you think you might need. Now, magnets. Some cruise lines are less magnetic than others. And by, I mean, like, Carnival doesn't have as much. Disney and Royal, like you can literally put these all over the wall. So these are good to like hang like excursion tickets, notes for each other, stuff like that. And then these, you have to get like the 40 or 50 pound one. I know that sounds a lot, but trust me, that's what you need. These you can put everywhere. You can hang like your purses, you can hang your hats, you can hang bathing suit in the bathroom. They just really come in. You can literally hang a lot. I like bringing a new pop-up hamper every time. I hate to say this. I usually leave a lot of these things on the cruise. I don't save them and reuse them. I'm not saying that's how everyone should do it. It just depends on how full my bag is. If I can fit it in there, if I haven't bought too much, I bring it home. But if I can't, I'm like, whatever. These are easy to hold. This is a new one, but honestly, like I used the same one for years. I just couldn't find it. These fold up very easily. These are great. You put all your dirty clothes in there and then it's just easier to see all your clean clothes. Now these honestly, I usually don't bring back. This, I usually get a new one every time because once it's open, it's like a hassle to fold again. But this is like a mesh over door hanger. This is great not only for shoes, but you can put your sunscreen, you can put a book, you can put your water bottles, you can put other, it's just very, it keeps the room tidy. Towel bands or towel clips. It gets windy on the ship, so you want a towel band to keep your towel in place. Clips, these only work on the top, so if you want one for the bottom, you need a clip. The towel clips also come in handy for curtains in your room. If you don't have a clip, you can also use a hanger. They don't give you a lot of hangers, so ask for more hangers right away or bring the foldable ones. That's another little tip. Bring something like this. I usually do the smaller ones for just your phone for excursions, but if you need to take like your passport or other documents, this one is great because you can fit more in it. And it goes, it's like waist, you know, you can put it on your waist if you want to get in the water and you don't want to leave it. So these are actually really good. Or you can do the ones that go over your neck. Any of those are fine. This is not a must for everyone, but it's a must for me. Their shampoo and conditioner and their body lotion and their shower gel is just not for me. I like using my own. So I like these little squeezy bottles that you can fill with your own. So I personally bring this. But again, it's a preference. It's not a necessity. I like being able to clean my bathing suits and let them dry or whatever. So I like having these little sudsies that you can just put in the sink, and the sink is tiny. Don't think you're gonna be able to do laundry. A lot of them do have laundry places, or you can send your laundry out if you feel the need to. Never have. This is always good to carry around, you know, if you spill something on yourself. Now, some little extras. If you're going on excursions, you're gonna be in the water, and you know you're prone to swimmer's ears, bring this. Bring it with you. Thank me later, because you'll probably pay like $50 for this. You can rent snorkeling gear. You can bring your own. Most places, you don't really need the flippers. You're fine with just the mask. We like this one because you can attach a GoPro to it, and it's all in one. You can do the old school ones. That's fine. You can do the full face if that's your thing, but I know they're banning those in Hawaii because they've been deemed unsafe lately, so warning. Depending on where you're going, water shoes, if you're going somewhere rocky, I would highly suggest these, or snorkeling, you can do these. So if you're going somewhere tropical in the Caribbean, sometimes you will get hit with like a quick storm. It may not last long, but if you don't want to get wet, I suggest bringing disposable ponchos, because then you just throw it out when you're done with it. I bring them all the time. I think I've only had to use them a couple times, but I was very happy to have them when I did need to use them. Speaking of, having a little GoPro that's waterproof, always a plus. And my last thing, which I have actually never brought on a cruise, but I saw this and I was like, you know what? That's actually a fun idea. I'm gonna do it, is to bring binoculars. And I was like, I don't wanna bring big ass binoculars. So I found these adorable little, look at that, fits in my small little hand. So I'm gonna bring these on my next cruise. Oh, I don't have this out here, but bring a highlighter to highlight the schedule, which you can clip on here. Everything obviously is in the app now, but some people like to put their phone away when they're on a cruise. I think I covered everything. If I forgot one of your cruise essentials, please comment down below. Let me know if there's any other kind of traveling tidbits you would like to hear from me. I will add one more thing. I don't know if most people are aware of this, but if you drink soda, water, wine, beer, what I think you can bring wine and beer. It's like one pack per adult in each stateroom. So, well, it depends on the cruise line. Disney, I think you can bring two bottles of wine per adult. Which is kind of funny. And I think Royal and Carnival are one per adult. And then you can bring like a 12 pack of soda. In addition to that, 12 pack of water. So yeah, check with your cruise line. Don't say that I said that you could bring all this. You know, make sure to check. Each cruise line is different. I like to bring a bottle of champagne. I tend to like to be on my balcony when we're sailing away, just kind of with like my friends or whatever. Some cruise lines do sail away parties that are more fun than others. It is what it is. Some people also just Just kidding, you know, it's a preference. But yeah, so those are my must-have cruising essentials. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time. Bye.